What's up guys, my name is Brian, and if you didn't know, I live in Greece. And the thing about here, there are a lot of riots between the young people against the police. Because the young people believe that the government here is corrupted. You know how we young people feel about the system, the government. The reason why government is corrupted is because the ministers took advantage of the power for their own gain, which led to the corruption of government. And whenever there's a corrupted government, there will always be a group of people who wants to change the system to make it better for justice reasons and whatever. Hello guys, my name is Brian and I'm gonna review Akame Ga Kill. Was that introduction good? Like, should I talk about that? Because I'm trying to transition to the story. The story follows a young boy named Tatsumi in which he goes to the capital in order to earn money to help his village because his village is poor or something. So this capital, which is called Imperial Capital, is famous because it's rich and full opportunities for young people like Tatsumi.
Little did he know that the capital was full of corruption.
The reason why the capital was corrupted was because the emperor was still a child. It's not corrupted because he was a spoiled brat. It was because of his inexperience, the prime minister, Honest, his name, had to help him rule the country, the emperor. And while helping him, he manipulates the emperor to do things in his own way for his own policy and his own selfishness. So like I said previously, in every corrupted country, there will always be a group of people who wants to go against the government or the system for justice. The name of this justice group is called the Night Raids. So this is an assassin group in which their main goal is to go and kill influential leaders and people in order to make the country a better place, obviously. So in a small assassin mission that the Night Raids had, Tatsumi gets involved in it. And because of that, he learns about how corrupted the country is. He also learns that two of his friends died because of the corruption. So after Tatsumi learns about the dark secret behind the capital, he eventually joins the Night Raids. For justice! And for revenge, but mostly for justice. So Night Raid is a small group of people. The reason why they're very strong is because each of the members carries an imperial arm. If you don't know what's imperial arm, the first emperor created 48 different kind of weapons with the help of the supernatural danger beast and a little bit of alchemy. And about these weapons, not everyone can use these weapons, you have to be compatible with it. And also another fact about it, if two users use it and fight one of them must die eventually. And also if they die, the imperial arms will be destroyed. Which somehow reminds me about the weapons in Guilty Crown, you can say. Okay guys, let's talk a little about the characters and the members of the Night Raids. I won't talk about all the members in the Night Raids. I just talk about the members that stood out for me. Like I mentioned before, we talk about Tatsumi. For me, Tatsumi is the most generic shonen character we normally have. I want to be stronger, I want to help my friends, friendship power, blah 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 blah, you get what I mean. Like a typical shonen character Tatsumi is, we have a lot of character development from him. Mainly because he's the protagonist of this series. What? Wait, from the title I thought it was Akame the main character. Isn't she the main character? Unfortunately, Akame doesn't have as much screen time as Tatsumi have. Seriously guys, they must call this series Tatsumi Ga Kill. Maybe Akame Ga Kill have a nice ring to it, eh? About Akame, the main protagonist, if you want to call it from the title, she doesn't have a lot of screen time, but she's a very important role in the whole series. Another character that I found really interesting was a member of the Night Raids called Bulat. In some animes, we see an affection between two male characters, mostly for comedic purposes, you can say. This is the first time in any anime which I heard that they mentioned straightforward that he's gay. Okay, disclaimer, I'm not gay. The reason why I found this interesting is first of all, they didn't hide the fact that he was gay and they said that the word gay, you know? It shows that not only the outside world and the culture is changing, but it shows also about the anime industry that they're changing and evolving and stuff. Aside from the gay people, let's talk a little about the feminists. In most anime, we always see the female character being the innocent, clumsy girl, there for comedic purposes or for fan service. Don't get me wrong, there is fan service here. Both in the Night Raid and the leader in the enemy side are both female characters. It's really refreshing to see girls who are badasses and overpowered. Seriously overpowered. Another thing about the characters, of course, you naturally want to support the good side, you know, the Night Raids. But by watching the series, you naturally get attracted to the enemy side also. So whenever the enemies and the good guys fight, you don't know which character to support because they're, SDF. Overall, the animation, for the most part, is average, I can say. But the action scenes, is really good, guys. Kinda reminds me Tokyo Ghoul / Fate series. Okay, let's not put it that high with the Fate series, but near to Fate series and also next to Tokyo Ghoul. I don't have a lot to say about the music, but It has a typical epic orchestra music in the fighting stage with really nice. And also you have that emotional, sad strings music. For me, the music's average. I didn't notice the music too much when I was watching the series. Currently, you can't find songs in YouTube about Akame Ga Kill. The action scenes make it up for the whole thing. So Brian, why are you telling me to watch this? What makes this unique, huh? Okay guys, the reason why I enjoyed this series. First of all, from the first episode, during the first episode in the first 10 minutes, seeing that the character is the generic shonen character, I wanted to drop it from that 10 minutes. But I said, okay, I will watch the whole first episode and then think about dropping or not. So while watching it, I was surprised that there were nice action scenes, which like I told before. But then I was more surprised about the gore part. This anime have a little bit of gore, but the overall theme of this anime is not dark. So it's okay, it's like Tokyo Ghoul style. So the action scene especially and the gore are good features about the series. So what makes this series different from the other series and makes it, you know, little unique, I would say is the death flag. Seriously guys, there are death flags everywhere. Everyone has a death flag. Death flags for everyone guys, take it. You don't know who will die, whether it be the enemies or the good guys. You don't know who will die and when they will die. One of my favorite animes like One Piece, they're a group of people, let's say like the Night Raid. One Piece crew, the Straw Hat crew and the Night Raids. They're a group of people. But subconsciously, I know that in One Piece, no matter how hard the struggles are, the members won't die. Like, I know until the end, I don't expect seeing a person die, because that's what keeps the series going, you know, the characters in the crew. But unlike Night Raid or the enemies group, you never know who will die, which puts a realistic sense to the anime that, you know, when they fight for justice, someone must sacrifice, and the good guys can't always win by killing all the enemies. Sometimes the enemies will die, sometimes the good guys will die. And that aspect gave me a good impression of this anime. And because of that aspect that everyone has a death flag and anyone can die anywhere, it always kept me on the edge of my seat, which I found interesting and what I enjoyed. So yes guys, this is my review for Akame Ga Kill, and I recommend you to watch. It's only 24 episodes, comments. You won't feel it's like a waste of time, and it's not like 100 episodes, so at least watch the first episode and you can have a general idea of the whole series from episode 1. Just watch episode 1. So thank you guys, this is my review, and yeah, go watch it now, go watch it. Go watch it. Okay, did they leave? Okay. Guys, I want to talk for the people who already watch a series. Obviously, everyone's gonna say this, the manga's way better, you have to read the manga. Obviously, the manga will always be better than the adaptation. This series don't have the best adaptation, I can say. First of all, for the series, I'm just an anime watcher. That's why I will give it a 7 out of 10. But if I read the manga, I think I might give a 6 out of 10. And I understand that the adaptation is not what you expect from the manga. That is the thing. From the middle of this series and on, it was going for an anime original. So you can't say, oh, the manga was way better. It's an original now. Officially an original, you can say. And of course, there were annoying parts with the time skips and all of that. White Fox didn't do the best job they can do with the adaptation, but of course they were trying to go for an anime original. The ending is an original, so if you read the manga, yeah, it's different from the ending of the anime series. They also have 24 episodes, which led them to be in a hurry with the anime, and with all the action scenes and stuff, you feel that it's forced on your face, like all the action, take it in your face guys, which I can understand. They had to force it in your face and for you to take it all and to accept things how they are because of the 24 episodes and because of White Fox, what can I say? As an anime-only watcher, I thought it was really enjoyable, and I know that obviously the manga's way better, but as an original, they did kind of good job. Talking about overall, it left me a good impression. The animes that make you angry and makes people discuss are the good animes. Like, if you can discuss about it and people are raging over it, you know, not raging because of the bad and things like that, but if they talk about it, I think it's considered a good anime, you can say. So thank you guys for watching this video. I make anime related videos. And if you want, subscribe and see you next time guys. Tell me in the comment below what you thought about Akame Ga Kill. And this is my first review, so tell me if I did a good job or if I forget to mention something or whatnot. Thank you guys, bye bye.